Welcome to the second part of IBD, inflammatory bowel disease. Now we will start with the symptoms associated with IBD. First is ulcerative. For ulcerative, we'll have a comparison of both. Both of them will show altered bowel movement, and that is mainly increased stool frequency or decreased stool frequency, consistency, not frequency. That is diarrhea with different type of stool consistencies. There is in Crohn's disease, you will have chronic nocturnal diarrhea. Whereas abdominal pain in ulcerative colitis can be localized to left lower quadrant, cramping, relieved with defecation. Whereas in abdominal pain of Crohn's disease, this postpartum is after eating right lower quadrant abdominal pain associated with distension. Hematochezia, that is blood in stool, may be seen in ulcerative colitis. Whereas in Crohn's disease, fever may be associated. As the lining of intestine becomes inflamed and ulcerated, it loses its ability to adequately process food and waste or absorb water, resulting in loose stool, diarrhea, in severe cases, weight loss. Inflammation can cause small ulcers to form in the colon and rectum. They can join together and become large ulcers that bleed, resulting in bloody stool. Blood loss can eventually lead to anemia if unchecked. So there is severe blood loss associated with stool as a part of ulceration. So these ulcers present in the colon and rectum may lead into bleeding. About their clinical features, as we have seen, ulcerative colitis is mainly localized to the large intestine, whereas Crohn's disease can be found in any segment. Rectum is usually involved. Rectum is usually not involved, and as they have skip lesions, because they are not continuously a part of the intestine, would be involved. Ulcerative colitis is mainly a mucosal disease, whereas this one is a transmural involving the entire thickness of intestinal wall. Ulcerative colitis, diffuse ulceration, granularity, fibrillity, bleeding, exudates can be found. Aphthous ulcer, serpingous ulcer, and cobblestoning. This feature of cobblestoning is a histopathological feature of Crohn's disease, where cobblestone appearance gives you a suggestion that Crohn's disease is present. No fistula and granulomas are formed in ulcerative colitis, whereas fistulas and granulomas are common finding in Crohn's disease. Also, looking into the extra-intestinal manifestations and what other symptoms we might find on ulcerative colitis, it is joint pain. Joint pain can be seen, aphthous ulceration of mouth, ankylosing spondylosis, pyoderma is pus formation in skin and usually gangrenous part. Erythema nodosum, and this one, as we have, if you remember, we have studied this type of affections in rheumatic fever, iritis, uveitis is also seen. In cases as a complication of ulcerative colitis. Whereas for Crohn's disease, again, arthralgia, inflammatory peripheral arthritis is also seen, ankylosing spondylitis, sweet syndrome, this is particularly uveitis, iridocyditis, and episcleritis. Now let us look into the complications of and comparative chart. Bleeding in ulcerative colitis is usually massive. As in Crohn's disease, bleeding may be present, but it's not too threatening. fibrosis, stenosis, and thickening of wall is late in hose pipe appearance in ulcerative colitis, whereas obstruction is very common because it's involving the entire thickness of the wall. Obstruction is very common. Perforation is rare in ulcerative colitis as only the mucosal layer is involved. Whereas in Crohn's disease, perforation is very common. Perforation is sort of a hole presentation or a hole penetrating to the entire thickness of the wall. Fistulas is rare in ulcerative colitis, common in Crohn's disease. And malignant changes are quite common in ulcerative colitis and quite rare in Crohn's disease. Now the diagnosis. The diagnosis of inflammatory bowel disease in adult requires a comprehensive physical examination and a thorough investigation into the history of patient. There are usually many tests, biopsies, endoscopy, stool examination, imaging techniques which are usually used for diagnosis, but the patient history and examination is quite relevant in diagnosing such disease. Now about the patient's history, what we need to know about the diarrhea and associated blood and mucus in the diarrhea, frequency and location of pain, vomiting, weight loss, extraintestinal manifestations. We also inquire into the presenting symptom that has occurred at any time in the past. When the disease flares up, what are the symptoms associated? Duration of the complaint, nocturnal awakening, that is that we have seen in Crohn's disease that patient do have a nocturnal diarrhea, and at what level is this affecting the person, and what are the usual social activities with which he or she gets affected. We also inquire about extraintestinal manifestations. We have seen the complications, so we also need to look into that. We also look into the stressful situations, and as one of the precipitating factor for IBD is stress. So we see the mood disorders and stressful condition in which he or she is working and its effect on the symptoms of IBD. Also any history of tuberculosis and any past medication, we need to see travel history, cigarette smoking and family history also need to be checked with the patient history. Now for the physical examination, in general we'll look at the general well-being of the patient, pallor, cachexia, nutritional status, pulse rate, blood pressure, body temperature, body weight and height. So this will give you in rough approximation that according to the age of the person, is the patient doing well. In abdomen, we'll look for any abnormal mass, distension, tenderness, rebound, guarding, any altered bowel movement, hepatomegaly, surgical scars. In the perianal region, we'll look into the tags, fissures, fistula, abscess. Digital rectal examination may also give you a rough idea about the scars formed in the rectal region. For other extraintestinal inspections, we need to look into the mouth for ulcers. We need to examine various joints for if pain is present. Also into the eye for uveitis, episcleritis, erythema, skin for erythema nodosum, also for pyoderma. Sweets disease, it's a skin disorder associated with neutrophilic dermatosis and other metabolic disease like of bone and liver need to be checked. Stool examination, we'll continue with stool examination and other examinations in the third and the last part of IBD.